laptops are a must-have for people who often work outside. Thin and light laptops are easy to carry, and their long battery life makes them more popular. This time, ChargerLAB got the Huawei MateBook X Pro. It adopts a three-stage PCB design and uses a variety of lightweight materials. It reduces weight while ensuring performance. So let's take a look at the performance of this laptop. It comes with a 140 watts power adapter and a dual USB-C cable. The 140 watts power adapter comes in pure white. The case is made of PC fire retardant material and has a smooth surface. The specs info are printed below the ROM. Model is HW-200700CP0. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz 2.5 amp. It can support output of 5 volts 2 amp, 9 volts 3 amp, 15 volts 3 amp, and 20 volts 7 amp. ChargerLAB Power's EKM003C shows it can support UFCS 140 watts FCP SCP QC 2.0 QC 5 DCP PD 3.0 and PPS charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 4.5 amp, and a set of PPS. It can support 4 sets of UFCS. 5.5 to 7 volts 4 amp, 7.0 to 10 volts 6.6 amp, 20 volts 7 amp, and 21 volts 6 amp. It is currently the first and only charger that supports UFCS 140 watts. The length of the dual USB-C cable is about 1.8 meters. The connectors are made of PC material and are engraved with 7 amp. Here is the USB-C to USB-A adapter which can connect USB-A devices such as mice, keyboards, etc. It also comes with the USB-C wired headphones. The laptop we got uses an Intel Ultra 7 processor and has 16 GB of memory and 1 TB of storage. You can also choose the version that adopts an Intel Ultra 9 processor, 32 GB of memory and 2 TB of storage. It is made of alloy and has a matte texture. It does feel light in the hand. It adopts a 14.2-inch OLED screen with a resolution of 2120 by 2080. The screen-to-body ratio is as high as 93%. It supports a 120 Hz refresh rate and a maximum brightness of 1000 nits. This screen also supports touch controls. The touchpad below the keyboard is made of glass and supports pressure sensing. It can simulate more realistic pressing feedback through the internal linear motor. The user experience is very similar to that of a MacBook. There are only 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports on the left side. The other side is the switch of the camera and the USB-C charging port. It has no 3.5mm headphone jack USB-A port or HDMI port. For users with expansion needs, a docking station is essential. It is only 13.5 millimeters at its thinnest point. And the weight is about 985 grams, much lighter than other thin and light laptops. We used some original chargers and some third-party chargers to test the compatibility of it. Use the original 140 watts power adapter to charge the MateBook X Pro. The real-time charging power is about 19 volts 7 amp 130 watts. The 2 Thunderbolt ports on the other side also support the same charging power. We have compiled the test results into a bar chart. Most chargers can reach their rated power. Third-party chargers are compatible with the 100 watts PD 3.0 protocol with a maximum power of 99 watts. There is no compatibility issue. We use the original 140 watts charger to fully charge the Huawei MateBook X Pro and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is always about 20 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 8 parts. In the first part, the power was about 80 watts for the first 3 minutes. Then the power increased to 136 watts and continued until 13 minutes. The power then dropped to 58 to 78 watts and lasted until 22 minutes. Then the power increased to 136 watts and continued until 25 minutes. The power then dropped to 90 watts and lasted until 31 minutes. Then the power increased to 136 watts and continued until 32 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 120 watts and 100 watts in turn. The final part begins at 38 minutes and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 35 minutes to be fully charged. It can reach 50% in 27 minutes and 80% in 44 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 1 hour and 35 minutes. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and 50 minutes. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 38.2 degrees Celsius. The heat is mainly concentrated in the middle area of the keyboard. The back is 35.3 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front increases to 47.6 degrees Celsius. The back is 42.7 degrees Celsius. After 50 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front drops to 35.2 degrees Celsius. The back is 34.3 degrees Celsius. We know from this chart that the temperature on the front is higher than on the back. The temperature is the highest at 30 minutes, which is 47.6 degrees Celsius. After 50 minutes of charging, the temperature has dropped to 38.2 degrees Celsius. The charging power was higher than 100 watts most of the time during the temperature test. So as an ultra-thin laptop, its heat dissipation performance is pretty good. Well, that would be all the tests for this laptop. It is only 13.5 millimeters at its thinnest point, and it weighs only 980 grams. It is compatible with the 140 watts proprietary protocol and PD 3.0 100 watts protocol. There are no compatibility issues. It takes 27 minutes to charge to 50%, but it takes 1 hour and 35 minutes to be fully charged. The temperature is the highest at 30 minutes, which is 47.6 degrees Celsius. But considering it is an ultra-thin laptop and has high charging power, its heat dissipation performance is still acceptable. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.